Hello, everyone. This is your professor once again, Professor Danny Araneta Kabulay, on the course Accountancy Research. We are now in week number 8, and we will be looking at video lectures number 36 to 40. For this particular episode, we will tackle the topic on formulating conclusions and recommendations. This is now the tail end of your research. If you're doing academic research or you're doing accountancy research. So let us start with this particular video. This is video lecture number 36. So for this particular week, we will be tackling four main topics. We'll look at summary of findings, conclusions, recommendations, and sample reports. So let's start the ball rolling. When we talk about summary of findings, we know that in chapter 3, we enumerated, we presented, we analyzed the data that we were able to gather, okay? So with that, these are your findings, so we need to show the results and we need to discuss those results. So, but that was in chapter 3 of your research, if you're doing academic research. But now, if you are doing academic research, we proceed now to chapter 4. This is now the final chapter of your academic research. And this begins with summary of findings. So everything that you were able to present, analyze, and interpret in chapter 3, you need to summarize them in a one or two pager. Okay, something very brief. So this is now the section called summary of findings. This is basically a synthesis of the detailed discussion in chapter 3 of an academic research, but should in no way be a replication of the previous chapter. So hindi mo lang siya copy and paste. Kailangan, kung halimbawa yung chapter 3 mo ay about maybe 15 to 20 pages, so this particular section is about maybe half page or one page, or at most two pages. So it should be very, very brief, okay? So you should not copy and paste. You should really capture the essence of the entire chapter 3. It is usually a purely narrative write-up with, as much as possible, no numerical values included. So all words, okay? Now, it is a recapitulation of the entire content of the research and does not contain any new information. So this is basically just summarizing. In many instances, summary of findings and conclusions are lumped together and presented together in one section in the last chapter of the research report. So usually, yung mga reports na ginagawa ng mga auditors, ng ating mga consultants, yung ginagamit na research sa accountancy practice, yung mga practitioners, hindi nila nilalagyan ng summary of findings. Diretso na kagad sa conclusion. So they just put together summary of findings and conclusions together. Okay, so wala na siyang separate section on summary of findings. It is important to note that in accountancy practice, this section is omitted in research reports like feasibility study, business plan, action plan, and even in industry reports. Pero yung mga iba, pwede siyang kasama. Okay? So let us look now at your exercise number 36, which you should be answering, and place your answers in the comment section below this video. So I'm challenging you. Which statement is false? I'm going to read out 5 statements, and then you tell me which one is not correct or false. Just type in the letter of your choice, okay? Take note, this is very, very tricky. So you have to really analyze very carefully. Akala mo tama yung sagot mo, yun pala hindi. So be careful, be very careful. So which statement is false? Let's start the ball rolling. A, summary of findings is omitted in a feasibility study, business plan, action plan, and industry report. B, summary of findings appears on chapter 4 of an academic research paper. C, summary of findings should not be a repetition of the findings of chapter 3, but more of a synthesis leading to the conclusions. D, summary of findings is an integral part of many research-based reports prepared by accountancy practitioners. And letter E, summary of findings can be found in Chapter 5 of the old APA research report format. So there you go. Is it A, B, C, D, or E? Type in your answer in the comment section below this video. I'll see you around. Stay tuned to video lecture number 37.